What's up, gamers? Laz here, and today we're going to be going through the Warden of Nothing Grandmaster Nightfall. There's a lot of similarities between Warden this season and Warden last season. As usual, I think you can complete this GM on any class, but for the most consistent clears, I'm going to have to recommend two Warlocks and a Hunter. Both Warlocks will be running the usual Chaos Reach with Geomags, and the Hunter will be on Bottom Tree Void with 6 Coyote. Keep in mind that all three champion types do make an appearance in this GM, so everyone's loadout will have to be on point. For weapons, we all ran the usual Anarchy in the heavy slot. Two of us used a Nightwatch Scout Rifle to deal with barriers, the other person used a Fatebringer to deal with overloads, we all used grenade launchers that had blinding nades. I ran a Truth Teller, we had an Orwings Maul, and an Empty Vessel. The mod department hasn't really changed all that much. Protective Light to help you stay alive when you're charged with light. Taking Charge to enable you to become charged with light. Charged Up to increase your stacks of charged with light, which also will increase the length of Protective Light. Personally, I used Warmind's Decree paired with Global Reach so my Truth Teller could potentially create Warmind cells. I recommend one of the Warlocks run Special Finisher so all the blinding GLs can stay stocked up on ammo. That same Warlock could also use Surge Detonators. That, paired with Anti-Barrier Scout Rifle and Unstoppable Grenade Launchers, will allow one person in the group to have something for all three champs. I think at least one person needs to be running Breach and Clear, but my group opted to have two people running it. We already know how dope it is, but it is a massive part of the boss room in this GM. Start off by stunning this overload idiot ASAP, then start working on the rest of the adds. Push up some to spawn the second wave of adds, restun the overload if you need to, clear out the rest of the adds, then work on the overload. Keep in mind that there are enemies in this first train area that can potentially wreck you. Once you drop down, make sure to take out this goblin before you drop to the next track. Sparrow your way to the end, but do not drop down with your sparrow. Take out the goblins in the exploding burials, push up to the doorway, deal with the Hydra, then start working on the Cabal enemies and the Unstoppable Champ. Once you're clear, push up and start taking out the enemies across the track. Once it's just the barrier, focus fire him down, then you can jump up on top of the train tracks and run all the way to the end, blinding any enemies you need to along the way. Once you're at the end, immediately deal with the few adds and the Unstoppable directly in front of you. Clear out the rest of the Cabal and start working on the barrier at the end. I recommend getting finishers here so you can stock up on special before you go to the next room. Take out these annoying adds here, then push up to spawn the first wave of enemies. Use these stairs as cover, take out the barrier on the top right, then have one Warlock pop a Chaos Reach on the Hydra and the adds around it. While that meme beam is going off, the other two can start working on the left side barrier. Clear out the remaining adds, then move up to spawn the next wave. Once the big idiot spawns, hit him with two Breach and Clear Anarchy shots and have the other Warlock meme beam him down. Once he's dead, gather any ammo you can and you're off to the next room. Take out the enemies on the right that are jumping out of the pods and be prepared for an Unstoppable to push you. If you can, grab as many special finishers as possible so you can have a stockpile of green bricks all the way back here. As you move forward, there will be another Unstoppable and more annoying adds. Take out the Unstoppable, focus on the Scion snipers whenever you see them, and once it's clear, run back to your ammo pile, restock, then go up the lift. In this arena, I recommend taking out the champs first, then clear out the remaining adds except for one. Save one add. While that add is still alive, run around the arena and set off those annoying mines. Once you're good, special finish the last guy and get anarchy traps on the left and right side spawn doors. Take out this barrier champ as fast as possible, then move down this hallway and take out the Unstoppable. Once the two champs are dead, have your Hunter get on the first mine, and have both Warlocks go to the Cabal mine. Use any supers needed to clear the Cabal side and capture the mine. Once the first mine is disabled, your Hunter can go to the third mine and abuse 6 Coyote and Invis to solo this mine. Or, a Warlock that still has a super could assist if needed. Make sure to stun and damage this annoying overload here so you can still get platinum. Once all the mines are dismantled, come to this spot, wait for the big Cabal dude to spawn, hit him with Anarchy, and if you ended up saving a Chaos Reach, meme beam this idiot. Once this guy dies, the rest of the enemies will despawn. Now that it's clear, run around and collect any ammo you can find and push on down. I recommend waiting until all three of you have your supers before you move forward. It'll make the boss room extremely easy. Go down just one at a time. No need to wipe because of a stupid collision between teammates. Stay on this platform and take out the Unstoppable and Overload champs from up here. Then jump down and start working on both barriers. Do not special finish here. Set up in the back of the room, and once the boss spawns, stick him with two anarchy shots, then pop your supers. Towards the end of your supers, the boss will teleport to either the left or right side. Stick him with two more anarchy shots, then have your hunter invis the entire fire team. Then the boss will die, and Warden of Nothing is a GG. You can catch me live several days a week at twitch.tv/LazarusC13. Link is down in the description. Leave a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video, or thumbs down if you didn't. That's cool too. Leaving a comment is also cool. Dropping a sub would be super dope. And Laz, out. I can't.